Hello you, hello traveler, and welcome back to the Definitely Greece channel. My name is Yota, and this is part 3 of our little series on ancient Greece. You might have heard that a few things were actually discovered in ancient Greece. We thought to put together a few of our favorite stories on things that were discovered in ancient Greece and tell the stories of a few discoveries that have stood the test of time and are still in use today. Don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and bell button for more awesome content about everything Greece, and let's dive into it. The first invention we're going to talk about today is known as the Antikythera mechanism. Antikythera is just a small island off the coast of the Peloponnese. And although the mechanism in antiquity was not used in the middle of the sea, but was actually in Athens, a long time ago it was attempted to be transferred. And unfortunately, the ship that carried it sunk to the bottom of the sea and was later discovered by divers. The Antikythera mechanism would be known as the world's first computers, as there would be over 100 functions that it was thought to have. Of those presumed functions, the ones that have been determined to be correct today is the prediction of solar and lunar eclipses and some other astronomical events. What's amazing about the Antikythera mechanism is that a device of its complexity would not be seen again until the 13th century AD. You can actually see the Antikythera mechanism today in the National Archaeological Museum in Athens. And although technically we don't still use it today, this device has inspired the advent of so many technologies. The second discovery we're going to talk about today may not be as fancy as you think, and that is urban water management. I know, not that hot of a subject, right? Do you remember how in history class we would learn that even 200 years ago, in most European cities, the residents would fill up buckets with the water waste and discard it over their balconies or windows? That is not what was happening in ancient Greece. One of the most notable examples of that was in the palace of Knossos, found in Crete. Knossos was the center point of the Minoan civilization and what today is known as the very beginning of Western civilization. The Minoan Empire is mostly known in history today due to the stories of the Minotaur and the incredible cultural events that would take place depicted throughout the palace. However, inside the palace would be one little marvel of the ancient world. That is a sanitation and sewage system that would no doubt compete with what was found in many European cities 200 years ago. A complex of underground terracotta pipes would transfer water, but also there were systems in place to heat it up for the bathhouses and a sewage system that would get rid of any dirty water. This makes the Minoans the first ones to use underground pipes to manage their water system. Which brings us to the second most notable example of managing urban water, a little bit more north in the island of Samos. Around 6th century BC, Samos was flourishing. A series of successful military campaigns from Samos would mean that the city and island would flourish like never before. That led to an important issue. As the city's population was growing, it was becoming harder and harder to manage the water. That's when a man known as Palinos decided to build the aqueduct of Samos. It was used continuously for over 1,000 years, and it gave the people of Samos the added advantage of having their water supply underground, which meant it was much harder for enemies to identify and attack in case of a siege. You can also visit the Samos Aqueduct today and discover some quirky facts about archaeology and engineering together. Following this, there's a very appetizing third discovery, which is none other than cheesecake. Now, I must admit, researching this story has made me realize how strongly people can really feel about cheesecake. And although there's great debate about every single part of the cheesecake, whether it should be baked, what the base should have, what the filling should have, or what the toppings should be, the first mention of cheesecake was in the island of Samos again, and it's over 4,000 years old. The recipe calls for cheese, wheat flour, and honey, and New Yorkers will be actually very glad to know that it was actually baked. Of course, the recipe throughout the millennia has been changed and upgraded many different ways, and almost every culture since ancient Greece has added their little twist. For example, after Greece was conquered by Rome, Romans would add eggs to the recipe and make it on special occasions to celebrate. Cheesecake is also noted in the ancient Olympics as having magical energy to sustain the athletes, as well as mentions of cheesecake in ancient Greek weddings. Drop us a comment below with your favorite Greek invention and perhaps with your favorite cheesecake recipe. Which brings us to vending machines. Although some of the first modern vending machines were made in London, over 2,000 years ago, a man known as Heron of Alexandria had an issue. People would go to the temples to pray, however, they would use up much more water than their allotment. That's when he had an idea to construct a little machine that every worshipper would have to insert a coin, and the weight of the coin would activate a lever. In turn, the lever would activate the water flow to the equivalent of the coin's weight. And thus, he solved his problem and perhaps created the world's first vending machine. If you find this kind of thing interesting, don't forget to check out the Museum of Ancient Greek Technologies in Athens. That houses models of a lot of ancient Greek inventions, and you can uncover the history of a lot more feats of ancient Greek engineering. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. I really hope you enjoyed this video and hope to see you in Greece soon.